Hey, what's up guys? I'm Tiger with Tiger Up Media, back with another Dokkan Battle video. So today marks the beginning of yet another celebration on Global, and as always, we're gonna find out what's going on together. So let's pop right in, here we go. And apparently they're calling this one the Transcend the Limit Awakening Challenge Special Campaign. Now, doesn't really matter what it's called, let's find out what's happening. Okay, first things first, we got a new SSR Metal Kura, or Cooler, whatever you want to say, is the same thing. We'll show up in Dokkan Festival. Grab the chance to summon the resurrected Kura. Sweet. Okay, in addition to luxurious login bonuses, there's also a new Dokkan event, Extreme Z Battle, and Extreme Z Dokkan Festival. Okay, cool. Number one, Transcend the Limit Awakening Challenge Special Mission. So, missions to complete to get free Dragon Stones, free Kais, some training items, all that good stuff. We'll do a full breakdown later on. Number two, we have the login bonuses, also a full breakdown on a separate page. Number three, we have the Dragon Stone sale. So it looks like it's going to be a 32 stone pack, one time only, 50% discount, and a 91 stone pack, 20% off, three times only. So a pretty standard Dragon Stone sale, nothing too crazy. But if you guys are saving stones for the 4-year anniversary, actually wouldn't be a bad idea to pick up that 32 stone pack. It's generally a pretty good deal. Now, if you're free to play, then obviously completely ignore this entire section. But if you are pay to play, then I'd say go for it. But anyways, number four, we have the new Dokkan Festival. Of course, there's the new AGL Meta Cooler. And like I said, extremely, extremely good unit. I mean, I didn't say it in this video, but in the past videos I talked about him, he's a very, very good unit. But at the same time, 4-year is kind of around the corner, only about 3 months away at this point. So I would say be kind of conservative with your stones. If you're gonna summon, do like 2 to 3 multis, call it a day. Cooler is definitely worth the summon, but I mean, like I said, crazy stuff around the corner, so don't spend too much. And it does look like it's gonna be very similar, if not the exact same banner as JP, with the future Gohan, as well as probably Jiren, and I totally forgot who else was on the banner, but anyways, I talked about it in a previous video, and I feel like it's gonna be the same as the JP banner. Some people were speculating, and I was hoping they would put Hit on our banner instead, but if he was on the banner, he would probably be on this image here, and he's not, so I'm gonna say no Hit on this banner. Okay, number five, category summon for the Wicked Bloodline, which is the new category brought in by the Metal Cooler. And I'm just gonna say skip this one, guys. Don't make the same mistake that I made on the Realm of Gods banner. We're not gonna talk about it too much, but I summoned 3 times on that banner, got completely shafted. It was a very sad time. I would have like 150 stones right now, but instead I have 40. So don't repeat that mistake. Just skip this banner. It's not worth it. All right, okay. Number six, new Dokkan event. This of course is the Metal Coolers event. Even if you don't end up pulling for the cooler, that's still 2 free stones right there, which is always nice. Moving on, at number 7, we have the return of the Metal Cooler story event, and all the SR Metal Coolers that drop from this event now have Dokkan Awakenings, and they make a very solid free-to-play team, so I would definitely recommend everybody to commit to that grind. It's gonna be worth it. Okay, number 8, we have a brand new Extreme Z Dokkan Festival, which means we have a brand new Extreme Z Battle and a brand new Extreme Z Awakening coming to Global, of course. This is for the Tech Beerus, and I am extremely excited for that because he is an absolute monster, and of course he is rainbow for your boy Tiger, so we're gonna do some nice things with him, can't wait for that. At number 9, we have the return of the Battle of Gods event. And number 10, the Strongest Rivals event is coming back. And at number 11, we have the brand new Tech Beerus Extreme Z Battle and Extreme Z Awakening. I'm so freaking excited. I'm pretty sure his weakness is Realm of Gods. Don't hold me to it, it's been a while since I've checked, so I could be wrong, but I'm 90% sure that his weakness is Realm of Gods, so get your Realm of Gods teams ready. And also, I mean, even if you don't care about the Beerus, even if you aren't that excited about him, that's still 30 plus free stones right there, so nobody can complain about that. And number 12, we have the return of the Cell EZA, which is also an indication that the Int Cell is getting an Extreme Z Awakening too, so you can use that event to farm up the medals for the Int Cell as well. And also, of course, if you didn't awaken your Tech Cell yet, then there's your chance right there. Numbers 13 and 14 are the Dokkan events for your Beerus and Cell, and they're gonna be available every single day during the event period so that you can farm the Awakening medals for your Tech Beerus or your Int Perfect Cell or Tech Perfect Cell. So there you go. And at number 15, we have the return of the Rebrienne Magic Girl Fighters event. And number 16, we have another waifu banner. Now, extra exciting is that we're also getting the Dokkan Awakenings for the STR Chi-Chi and the Tech Bula. Both of them are very good, but especially this Tech Bula, guys. If you don't know what she does, she is actually one of the best support units in this entire game. When she Dokkan Awakens, her passive will be Ki plus 3 and attack plus 40% for all allies, in addition to the dodging I think she had before. So absolutely insane support unit, and I'm definitely looking forward to that. At number 17, we have the return of the Other World event. And last but not least, at number 18, the 7th Virtual Dokkan Ultimate Clash on Global or Dokkan Battlefield, whatever you guys want to call it. All I see is 40 to 50 more Freestones, and also my final dupe for the LR Metal Cooler. Actually, maybe it's my third or fourth dupe, but either way, another dupe for the Metal Cooler, and also a bunch of free stones, and of course your boy will be streaming it as always, so keep an eye out for that. But that's gonna do it, guys, for all the updates for this specific celebration on Global. It looks pretty good to me. I think it's pretty decent. We've had some better ones, we had some worse ones. Either way, it's a new celebration, it's more content, and that's definitely something we've been needing on Global. I don't think any Global player can disagree with that statement. But let's check out the login bonuses and the missions real quick, just to see what's going on over there. So it looks like we can get up to a total of 44 free Dragon Stones for completing all the missions, which is not too bad. So it's going to be one per day for completing three stages, and then two for 10 story events, two for five Dokkan events, two for five Extreme Z battle wins, one for 300 stamina, two for 700, three for 1000 stamina, 3 for completing 10 of the missions, and then 7 for completing all the missions. Of course, this is in addition to all the Hercules statues, awakening medals, trading items, and all that good stuff. So, not too bad overall. And for the login bonus, I believe we're getting 1 stone per day every single day for the entire event. Yeah, so 1 stone per day for a total of 22 stones. And of course, in addition, we're getting some Kais, orbs, training items, support items, all that good stuff. Pretty standard stuff if you ask me, and that's pretty much gonna do it, guys, for today's video. Hope you enjoyed it, and also let me know in the comments down below which of these new events you're the most excited for. And also, I want to hear who is gonna be summoning for the AGL Metal Cooler banner and how many stones you plan to spend, because I know most people are probably gonna skip this one, but I'm also curious to hear who isn't. So let me know in the comments down below. And that's all from me. As always, if you guys like the video, then make sure to like the damn video. And if it's your first time watching me, first time to the channel, you'll like what you see, then make sure to hit that big red subscribe button to join the Tiger Squad now. And while you're at it, hit that notification bell so that YouTube knows you want to stay up to date with all of my latest content. But that's it. I'm out of here. Hope you guys have a fantastic day. I'm Tiger with Tiger Upcoming Media, signing out.